Risk factors include having no children and being overweight. It is more likely that Maria had cervical cancer. This tends to affect younger women, and the risk increases after having 5 full-term pregnancies. It often remains symptomless until at an advanced stage. Cancer can, of course, defy any broad grouping of its victims. But whatever the origin of the tumour, it was killing her, and the parsonage reverberated with shock. Of the little that has been written about Maria Branwell, there tends to be the assumption that she was delicate because she was small. In fact, all the evidence on Maria's health before 1821 reveals the direct opposite. She was a strong and healthy woman. She had been raised in a comfortable home, with good food, sea air, and access to doctors. She had dodged whatever had carried off her 7 siblings. The 3-year-old Elizabeth and 4-year-old Thomas, then the babies, 2nd Thomas and both Alice's before she was born, adult sisters Anne and Margaret when she was a child. Maria made the arduous solo journey from Penzance, had 6 healthy pregnancies and survived childbirth. She walked everywhere. Elizabeth Branwell was also petite, but strong well into her 60s. Maria's offspring, apart from Emily, who was tall like her father, may have resembled little dolls in stature, but they too were healthy in their early years. Maria did not fall ill because she was always frail. In 1821, as today, a robust constitution was no defence against an aggressive and incurable disease. Though clearly terminally ill, Maria did not die immediately as feared.